Good evening and welcome to Poland Daily. I'm Nicholas Richardson and this is the news. President Andrzej Duda has started his re-election campaign tour of Poland. The president intends to visit over 100 towns and cities. The first stops were in Łowicz and Turek in central Poland. In Łowicz, Duda received an enthusiastic welcome despite a group of opponents trying to disrupt his rally.
President Andrzej Duda inaugurated his election campaign last Saturday. During today's election rally, he stressed that the most important goal of his presidency is to bring a higher standard of living for all Poles. He also expressed his desire to meet the greatest possible number of people. This is also an important matter to take care of in our Polish Republic. Polish agriculture, to develop our country by supporting Polish families. This is the program which I have been fulfilling for the last 5 years, and today I am coming with this program to you. I want to continue it. I want Poland to continue its dynamic growth as it has during the last few years. We are very happy that the president has visited Łowicz. We will vote for him. We stand behind him. I have lived all my years and finally I could see the real president. This is the type of leader who is giving you an assurance of peace and stability, and this is what matters. It was a bit difficult because we have some noisy out-of-town visitors who have behaved very poorly. However, in my opinion, the president is the best president we have had so far. How did you like today's speech? I have heard little because over there the opposition raised a big racket, but the president did not give up, continuing his speech. I liked it very much, truthfully. He is a super nice man with great manners. No other candidates' parties, just him, only him, superhuman being.
A summit of the leaders of the European Union member states began in Brussels this afternoon. The main subject of the talks is the EU budget for the next 7-year budget term, beginning in 2021, which is already dividing member states. The Polish Prime Minister, Mateusz Morawiecki, spoke before the summit about Polish expectations for the future budget, urging there be no reductions.
We definitely want to improve Poland's position in several areas, and we are very glad because we already received very interesting offers. Our talks with President Charles Michel and President of the European Commission, Ursula von der Leyen, brought results. The new propositions are better than the ones we received before. We will be fighting for Poland's interests and to give equal terms to countries which were for several dozen years under the communist regime, which wasn't their fault. Today, these countries are becoming more and more independent in terms of the level of their development, and it's our primary goal to develop even more.
Yesterday, 9 people were shot dead, at least 5 of whom were Turkish citizens, and 6 were injured in the western German city of Hanau. After the shooting, the victims, the gunman shot dead his mother and committed suicide. According to the federal prosecutor, there are signs that the killer had xenophobic motives. German Chancellor Angela Merkel condemned the crime.
The attacks took place in the city of Hanau in western Germany on Wednesday in the late evening. The first shots were fired in the city centre around 10 p.m., after which the gunman entered a shisha bar, shot 3 people and wounded several others before driving off in a black car. The second attack took place several minutes later, 2.5 kilometers away, in a similar bar in the district of Kesselstadt. 5 people were killed and several others were injured. One of those injured later died in the hospital. Witnesses to both events were not sure whether the gunman was acting alone or with others. Around 10 o'clock yesterday evening, we received several calls informing us about 2 attacks in 2 different places in Hanau. The first policeman that arrived at the scene said the shots were fired both on Heumarkt and Kurt Schumacher Square. 8 people were killed during the shooting. I got a call from a friend that there was a shootout near the kiosk, so I rushed there immediately. I later heard that my father and younger brother were wounded and hid behind a kiosk. Later I saw them both, they were terrified and crying. Everyone was shocked. Ultimately, the police determined that the attacker acted alone. He was identified as a 43-year-old Tobias Ratjen, a German citizen. The man had a permit for hunting weapons. His body was found in his home after he most likely committed suicide. The body of the killer's mother was also found in the house. When special police troops entered the house, two bodies were found inside. One of them was a 72-year-old woman and the suspect. They had both suffered gunshot wounds. The murder weapon was found next to the suspect's body. The first results of the evaluation of the suspect's website indicate xenophobic motives. Police found a 24-page letter and a video at the home of Tobias Ratjen in which he pleaded guilty. The letter shows that the killer had extremist sympathies. We will do everything in our power to explain the background of these horrific killings. At present, there are many reasons to state that the perpetrator acted based on extremist right-wing, racist motivations. He acted out of hatred for people of a different origin, religion, or appearance.
Anderem Glauben oder anderem Aussehen.
A few months ago, a right-wing extremist attempted to break into a synagogue in Halle. Two people were killed in the attack and several others were injured.
The presidential campaign in the United States is gaining momentum. On Saturday, the Democratic Party candidates will compete in the Nevada primary. The billionaire, ex-mayor of New York, Michael Bloomberg, isn't on the ballot in that state, but did participate yesterday in a debate between the candidates. Meanwhile, President Donald Trump was seen in California, where he was raising funds for his campaign. Malgorzata Schultz reports for us from Los Angeles.
Donald Trump is visiting California. The US president came to Los Angeles in the afternoon, local time, where he held several meetings in Beverly Hills, including a fundraising luncheon. After that, Trump went to Las Vegas, only to return to California on Wednesday, where he again held meetings with fans in Palm Springs, as well as an important fundraising meeting, tickets to which cost $100,000 per person, while $120,000 had to be paid in order to sit at the president's table. From Los Angeles, for TV Republika, Małgorzata Schulz.
Los Angeles, specjalnie dla Telewizji Republika, Małgorzata Schulz.
That's the news. Thank you for watching. Stay with us for the weather, business, history, culture, and travel. But from me, it's have a good night and a better tomorrow.